وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to another episode of Quran Circle 7, where we listen to the recitation of the Quran and specifically talking about matters of al-Iman, matters of belief and the believers, the characteristics of the believers and what does it mean to be upon the faith and upon matters of al-Iman according to the proper belief of it, and how what we see from the verses of the Quran that includes matters of belief, matters of aqidah, matters of creed, matters of actions, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, halal, haram, etiquettes, everything in the deen of Allah and the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be related to matters of al-Iman, increases the Iman, decreases one's faith with sins and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what negates that, matters of disbelief, wal'iyadhu billah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Before we start listening to some of the verses in Surah Al-Baqarah, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We have Sheikh Ahmed Rajab. Welcome to the program.
Welcome.
Barakallahu feek. Sheikh Ayman Abdul Munim. Barakallahu feek. Jazakallahu khairan for coming. Sheikh Asad Al-Hawi. Welcome to the program. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Sheikh Fathi Khalif. Barakallahu feek. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. And inshallah ta'ala we'll go through the verses and as usual, briefly talking about some of the meanings of matters again of al-Iman, matters of faith, the believers and the belief itself. We'll start with Sheikh Ahmed and Surah Al-Baqarah, and he'll recite to us, inshallah, from verse number 232. Go ahead, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Wa idha talaqtumun nisaa fabalaghna ajalahun فلا تعضلوهن أن ينكحن أزواجهن إذا تراضوا بينهم بالمعروف ذلك يوعظ به من كان منكم يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر ذلكم أزكى لكم وأطهر والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون والوالدات يرضعن أولادهن حولين كاملين لمن أراد أن يتم الرضاعة وعلى المولود له رزقهن وكسوتهن بالمعروف لا تكلف نفس إلا وسعها لا تضار والدة بولدها ولا مولود له بولده وعلى الوارث مثل ذلك فإن أرادا فصالا عن تراض منهما وتشاور فلا جناح عليهما وَإِنْ أَرَدْتُمْ أَن تَسْتَرْضِعُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذَا سَلَّمْتُمْ ما آتيتم بالمعروف واتقوا الله واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله بما تعملون بصير والذين يتوفون منكم ويذرون أزواجا يتربصن بأنفسهن أربعة أشهر وعشرا فإذا بلغن أجلهن فلا جناح عليكم فيما فعلن في أنفسهن بالمعروف والله بما تعملون خبير ولا جناح عليكم فيما عرضتم به من خطبة النساء أو أكننتم في أنفسكم علم الله أنكم ستذكرونهن ولكن لا تواعدوهن سرا ولكن لا تواعدوهن سرا إلا أن تقولوا قولا معروفا ولا تعزموا عقدة النكاح حتى يبلغ الكتاب أجله واعلموا أن الله يعلم ما في أنفسكم فاحذروه واعلموا أن الله غفور حليم.
بارك الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا. These verses talks about matters of divorce and marriage and rulings, and it's of course related to the subject of al-iman because this is what al-iman is all about. It's about actions, whether it's halal or haram, and the iman and the faith increases and increases with the good deeds and decreases with the bad deeds. But there's something interesting here in the verses, as we heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention the belief in Allah and in the last day when it comes to a specific ruling with divorce. And this case or this specific mas'ala or the specific matter is that if a wife divorces her husband and after the iddah period has passed, which is 3 months, the guardians, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the guardian of the woman not to prevent her from going back to her husband if they both will to be reunited again. And this has an incident at the time of the Prophet والسلام, where one of the companions of the Prophet والسلام, he got someone married to his sister and he kind of did a favor to him. But then afterwards this man divorced his wife and the guardian, which is the brother of that sister, he refused to bring them back together when they wanted to be back together. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this verse. So when the verse was revealed, immediately this companion of the Prophet ﷺ submitted himself to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the guardian, and he made them reunited again. So therefore, this shows that how the effect of the iman in the heart, something that is against one's desire, against one's culture maybe, or things of that nature, but the verses of the Quran comes down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to them that this is what needs to be done, immediately submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that shows again the effect of matters of al-iman in relationships, in matters of marriage and divorces and things of that nature, and of course with the other rulings, and to have the knowledge and the certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's inside of you. So warn yourself against the punishment of Allah and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiver. He's the most forbearing subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next, inshallah ta'ala, Sheikh Ayman, and with some verses more to recite for us, inshallah.
Go ahead, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. فلما فصل طالوت بالجنود قال إن الله مبتليكم بنهر فمن شرب منه فليس مني قال إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي إِلَّا مَنِ اغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِّنْهُمْ فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَهُ هُوَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ قَالَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا اللَّهِ كَمْ مِنْ فِئَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِئَةً كَثِيرَةً كَمْ مِنْ فِئَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِئَةً كَثِيرَةً بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ والله مع الصابرين ولما برزوا لجالوت وجنوده قالوا ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا قالوا ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين فهزموهم بإذن الله وقتل داود جالوت وآتاه الله الملك والحكمة وعلمه مما يشاء ولولا دفع الله الناس بعضهم ببعض لفسدت الأرض ولكن الله ذو فضل على العالمين تلك آيات الله نتلوها عليك بالحق وإنك لمن المرسلين تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض منهم من كلم الله ورفع بعضهم درجات وآتينا عيسى ابن مريم البينات وأيدناه بروح القدس ولو شاء الله ما اقتتل الذين من بعدهم من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات ولكن اختلفوا ولو شاء الله ما اقتتل الذين من بعدهم من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات ولكن اختلفوا فمنهم من آمن ومنهم من كفر ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا مما رزقناكم أنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة والكافرون هم الظالمون الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم.
ما شاء الله بارك الله فيك. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى reward you. As you see these verses, at first it talked about struggle between the people of al-Iman, the people of faith, and the people of falsehood, and the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that governs this relationship of struggle. And the believers are the ones that stood fast and they were obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they did not rush into following their desires in the famous story between Talut and Jalut. And when the people said that they have no power whatsoever to face their enemies, those who have the strong conviction in meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment, they made it very clear that it's not just about the physical means that they have, but rather there's something else with matters of al-Iman, with matters of faith, that when people are upon al-Iman and faith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them victory, even if they are small in number, even if they are less in power, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid them, would support them. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He aided the believers and He gave them patience when they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that for the believers to reflect upon. And this is from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being addressing the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and the believers. Also it talks about that when people, those who believed in Allah, they are always victorious with matters of al-Iman. In this life, not necessarily immediately with the physical victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for them to be steadfast and firm upon matters of belief, calling the believers to spend from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for them before the Day of Judgment comes. So there's always that link. Why do the believers, they do the good deeds? For the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do the good deeds seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in this world, but rather in the hereafter. And this is what al-Iman entitles, for people to seek rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. We heard the most virtue, the most important verse in the Quran, Ayatul Kursi, that talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is the one that people believe in, and He is the one that people submit themselves to, because of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. So therefore, this is what fills their heart with matters of faith, with matters of al-Iman, that makes it easy for them to be upon what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. We continue inshallah ta'ala, and with Shaykh Asad, go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. La ikraha fid din, qad tabayyana ar-rushd min al-ghayy. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى لَا انْفِصَامَ لَهَا وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ اللَّهُ وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون ألم تر إلى الذي حاج إبراهيم في ربه أن آتاه الله الملك إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت قال أنا أحيي وأميت قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأت بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها قال أنى يحيي هذه الله قال أنى يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها فأماته الله 100 عام ثم بعثه قال كم لبثت قال لبثت يوما أو بعض يوم قال بل لبثت 100 عام فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنه وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى العظام كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما فلما تبين له قال أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير وإذ قال إبراهيم رب أرني كيف تحيي الموتى قال أولم تؤمن قال بلى ولكن ليطمئن قلبي قال فخذ 4 من الطير فصرهن إليك ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعهن يأتينك سعيا واعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. As we hear that al-iman or faith makes the person doesn't need to be forced to be upon it. It's something that is natural for the believers, and that's why there's no coercion in matters of the religion. For those who will and wish to be among the believers, this is for them. And if they choose to continue to be among the disbelievers, it's also against them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich. The verses also talks about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that supports the believers, and He takes them out from the darknesses to the light. And the disbelievers, the taghut, the evil things, the things that they worship besides Allah, the shaitan and the like of this, is their support. And of course, what is the comparison here? There's no comparison whatsoever, which shows the virtue of al-Iman. Then it talks about some of the things that happened before the Prophet ﷺ, with prophets of Allah, with things that they faced because of their faith and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them steadfastness, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed His signs and His ayat for people to confirm and to be affirm upon their matters of their belief, and to witness the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with matters of the belief in the hereafter. And this is how the believers, they establish the iman, the faith, when they look at the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to elevate themselves from one level of iman to level of certainty, and to keep on elevating themselves when they're affirming and confirming matters of belief in the hearts. We continue, inshallah ta'ala, with Sheikh Fathi. Go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tubtilu sadaqatikum bil manni wal adha kalladhi yunfiqu malah كالذي ينفق ماله رئاء الناس ولا يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فمثله كمثل صفوان عليه تراب فأصابه وابل فتركه صلدا لا يقدرون على شيء مما كسبوا والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين ومثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم ابتغاء مرضات الله وتثبيتا من أنفسهم كمثل جنة بربوة أصابها وابل فآتت أكلها ضعفين فإن لم يصبها وابل فطل والله بما تعملون بصير أيود أحدكم أن تكون له جنة من نخيل وأعناب تجري من تحتها الأنهار له فيها من كل الثمرات وأصابه الكبر وله ذرية ضعفاء فأصابها إعصار فيه نار فاحترقت كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تتفكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد
بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا These verses talks about matters of al-iman with regards to spending for the sake of Allah. And there's always a strong relationship between faith and spending for the sake of Allah. And that's why the Prophet والسلام, when he said, وَالصَّدَقَةُ burhan, الصدقة, charity is an evidence. Evidence of what? Evidence of al-iman, evidence of matters of belief. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling the believers to give for the sake of Allah and not to waste it, not to render it in vain when they would remind the poor with their charities and how they did favors to them. They should do it for the sake of Allah, seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. It's by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He make it easy for the believers when He set examples for them, as it's mentioned in the verses, parables, for them to be encouraged to give for the sake of Allah. Human beings, they need these types of examples and parables, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is the like of a speech, to give that strength to the hearts of the believers, because as a matter of fact, the human beings, they love so much the wealth and the materialistic things in this world. But what makes the person give for the sake of Allah is one's faith, one's belief seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the believers to spend from what's pure of their earnings. That means they have two orders here: to earn what's halal and to put the effort to make sure that they earn what's permissible for them, so that they would give charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for them, and to have the belief and the conviction that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich. He does not need anyone, but rather the believers are the ones in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So beautiful verses. We need to act upon them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who do. And we'll go to break inshallah ta'ala, come back with more verses from Surah Al-Baqarah that talks about matters of al-Iman. So stick around and stay with us inshallah. We'll be right back.
إذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome back. And with more beautiful recitation of verses in the Quran that talks about matters of an iman, faith, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen our iman and to keep us among strong iman, complete iman, till we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with Sheikh Ahmed and some of the verses in Surah Al-Baqarah. Go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وأقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. يا اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا إن كنتم مؤمنين. فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله فلكم رؤوس أموالكم لا تظلمون ولا تظلمون. وإن كان ذو عسرة فنظرة إلى ميسرة وأن تصدقوا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيك. الله يكرمك. As you see, this is something that is repeated throughout the entire Quran. The subject of al-iman wal-amal al-salih, matters of faith and the righteous good deeds. In these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned al-iman, faith, and righteous good deeds in general, and then specifically establishing the salah, giving the zakah. For these people, they have the ultimate success and joy in this life and in the hereafter. They have the rewards with the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No fear for them, nor shall they grieve. So that we really take away from our hearts this false belief that some people have, in which they think that as long as you have some faith in your heart, that is sufficient for you. No, it's not sufficient, because this is what the Quran says. You have to have al-iman, faith, and righteous good deeds. and to establish what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to establish. And part of that, part of the deen, part of our faith, is to stay away from riba, to stay away from usury. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling the believers, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. This is not an easy matter. This is not something to look down upon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is basically declaring war against those who deal with riba, usury. And that's why we need to know the rulings of it. We need to ask the people of knowledge, but we need to be warned against it, because this is a call for the believers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. O you who believe, اتقوا الله, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shield yourself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَى إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are believers, then stay away from it. And do not deal with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid. Otherwise, it's a war from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, opening the gates for repentance. If you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. Rules that governs the relationship between people, taking loans, giving loans, that if a person is in matters that is tight for him, is not easy for him to pay back, he does not have the means to pay back, then to give him time and not to cause him to be in any form of trouble, and to remember and to shield oneself from a day that everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how the believers, they bring the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hearts and they benefit from it. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with Sheikh Ayman. Go ahead inshallah and recite for us.
Inshallah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
Amen. بارك الله فيك. جزاكم الله خيرا. There's a great benefit in these verses, and these are treasures, as the Prophet ﷺ called them. Whoever recites these two verses at night, kafateh, would suffice for him. Suffice for him whether it's the good deeds in that night, in that particular night, or suffice for him with the night prayer. And this is something that the people of knowledge, they mentioned. But one of the very important thing that we need to reflect upon this here, the barakah, the blessings of the submission of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ to the orders of Allah, bless this ummah, as we hear in these verses. And it's the same thing happens to every believer. If you put forward in one's heart the submission, total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you think that this is might be over your capacity, which is of course not, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees in the hearts of the believers this full submission to the orders of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless them with ease. So when it comes to matters of holding fast to the deen, submit yourself. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, you would see amazing things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you to repent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you to be steadfast on the deen of Allah. And don't rely upon your own self, but rather rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Really, the two verses that we heard, we don't have the time to reflect upon them and to even you know, give more and more of the benefits of it, but we'll leave it inshallah ta'ala for now, and we continue with more verses and with Sheikh Asad from Surah Ali Imran. Go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه وأنزل التوراة والإنجيل من قبل هدى للناس وأنزل الفرقان إن الذين كفروا بآيات الله لهم عذاب شديد والله عزيز ذو انتقام إن الله لا يخفى عليه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله والراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب
بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا. This is the beginning of Surah Ali Imran. And the beginning of the Surah talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is definitely something that is foundation of matters of al-Iman. That the believers, they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. They believe in Him with His names and attributes. They believe in the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed and the previous books. And this is means of guidance to the people. And by the way, it praises the knowledge. And this is the knowledge. The knowledge is the wahi revelation from Allah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He talked about الرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ, those who are well established in knowledge, they state the fact that they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is how we get to know the faith with matters of revelation. This is how the way that we get to know the revelation is with ilm, with knowledge. And this is where the prophets of Allah, they brought the people the knowledge, and human beings, they have this capacity for them to learn what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. And that the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which requires knowledge, has verses that are very clear, muhkamat, and other verses of the Qur'an that might mean more than one thing. And the way of the people of knowledge is that they refer the meaning of the ones that are not clear to the ones that are clear. So there's no contradiction in the verses of Allah, in the Qur'an, in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how a person establishes his iman and his faith in his heart with matters of knowledge, with the proper knowledge in understanding the verses of the Qur'an, the muhkam of it and the mutashabih of it, the clear verses, and the non-clear verses, with knowledge it becomes clear when it's explained in the light of what is clear. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses, and Sheikh Fathi has a recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب لا يتخذ المؤمنون الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين ومن يفعل ذلك فليس من الله في شيء إلا أن تتقوا منهم تقاة ويحذركم الله نفسه وإلى الله المصير قل إن تخفوا ما في صدوركم أو تبدوه يعلمه الله ويعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله على كل شيء قدير يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا ويحذركم الله نفسه والله رؤوف بالعباد
الله خيرا يا الله سبحانه وتعالى يرضي الله يبارك فيكم. As you hear, this is verses talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth, and therefore the believers, since we're talking about matters of al-iman, as it's mentioned in the verses, part of their faith entitles for them not to be supportive of the disbelievers against the believers. It negates their faith. It's something that does not make sense. That's why the believers, they are one. They're one community. They're upon the same thing. So they need to support one another, unless there are specific rulings. And this comes also with matters of knowledge, where people need to seek what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. And before that, it talked about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that gives sovereignty to whoever he wills, and he takes that away from whoever he wills. Night and day and everything is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, life and death, and therefore also rulings and obedience should be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, full submission to the orders of Allah, and this is the essence of al-Iman. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala next time, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all with al-Iman. And before we end, I would like to thank the mashayikh, the reciters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all for coming and sharing these beautiful recitation, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all among the people of the Quran. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi.